Hi ladies, Andrea Twarowski here, helping you succeed in your online business now and not yesterday, okay? So interesting topic is I want to talk to everybody about how to not experience burnout and how to not get overwhelmed. When I first started my own business when I was 19, I always thought, you know, well, that would be a good problem to have when I have too many clients, too many things to do. That will be awesome, right? And it is a good problem to have. But if you're not careful, you can get burnt out. You can start resenting your business. Your family life also suffers because you're never spending time with them or you're not doing things that you need to do to kind of keep the house afloat. So there are ways to not experience this. If you have already, that's okay, but now it's time to pick yourself up from that. And even that's how I can talk about it, because I did myself experience burnout where I was exhausted. I was mad all the time. I felt that I was always like work, because a lot of people don't understand when you work from home, you're still working. You're not sitting at home in your pajamas watching movies all day. You have to work because that's where your income comes in. You can't have a lazy day. Because that's where the income comes in until you learn passive profits and automation. But I'll talk about that more in another video, but that's kind of what helped me experience less burnout. But anyways, I'll talk about that in another video because that's something totally different. That's just pretty much where you are letting automation do the work for you. So you don't have to be sitting in front of your computer all the time. You are letting automation or an assistant send out certain emails, send out certain products, and do all of these other things for you. But we'll talk about that some other time. But for today, yes, so how to not experience burnout. So when you're new at this, when you have a new shop, a new business, anything, you do have the mentality of work, because you need to get the work out there to obviously have things to sell, right? And you want to make customers happy. So anytime you have an order, you may not have it there with you. So you have to make it. You have to make it as quick as possible with good quality to get it out there so that the customers are happy, right? But something that I highly recommend is if your shop is doing well and you do have to create every single day, hire somebody else to do the other things for you and take breaks. So let me explain how this works. So what I did, and that helps me tremendously, is hire a housekeeper. Hire somebody to clean your house. Hire somebody to put away the laundry. Hire somebody to do the laundry. Whatever it takes that will allow you to have more time to create, and then also more time, say, over the weekends to relax with your family. Because at least I feel during the week, like my fiance Tom, he works like 8:30 till about 5 o'clock, right? So I feel that time, I don't feel bad when I'm working because he's not home. You know, he's working, I'm working. But when he comes home, I do feel bad if I'm on my cell phone constantly because, you know, he wants to spend time with me, right? And I want to spend time with him. But if I'm constantly checking emails, I'm constantly talking to customers, like constantly doing this, I'm constantly checking to see if the website's working, you know, checking Facebook, whatever, that's not helping him either. So you need to kind of think of things that you have to do, but then do it in certain times. So Tom isn't home during the week from 8 till 5. So that's when I focus on doing my work. If I might not have a lot of work to do that week, then I'll take Thursday to clean the house or whatever, right? But if I know that I'll be working every single day because I have a lot of new clients, then I will have my housekeeper come a little bit more that week to put away the laundry, to clean the house, to even cook sometimes. You know, that's okay. There's no shame and there's no harm in hiring somebody to do those things for you, because is your time better spent doing those things or working to make the money? I mean, you do have to think about that. And if you have kids, don't be afraid to even hire a part-time babysitter. So then that way you can get your work done and not feel bad, because having kids at home is tricky because they always want to spend time with you, right? That's just what they want to do. So it is a little bit tricky, but don't be afraid to do those things. If your business is doing so well that you're able to hire out, then that's amazing. You need to do that. Consider an investment, and that is a business expense, by the way. when you pay the housekeeper, save the receipts, because that is a business expense. That's what I use as my business expenses, because that's part of helping my business run smoothly. But let's just say you're not at that point yet. You are feeling overworked and busy, but it's not because you're selling a lot of things. It could be because you feel you have to make the website now. You have to answer the emails now. You have to create a newsletter. You have to create a new Facebook page. You have to rebrand. You have to talk to customers. So you may not be getting sales, but you may be feeling like you have to do a little bit of everything. What I do suggest is hire a social media manager. This is what I do for my clients, and they thank me every single time. 100% of my clients have been so happy, because once you hire a social media manager, what we do is we post for you on social media. We know what to post, when to post, and how to post to boost interaction. So then that way people are always seeing your products, seeing your positive testimonials. They are always seeing you out there without you having to do the work, because this can eat up hours every single day. And it's not exactly something fun for you to do, because you're not seeing the money from it right away. You will see the money in sales though, because the more people see your work from posting on social media and posting properly, that's the key. A lot of people don't know how to post for their brand, and they post incorrectly and they don't get any sales and they don't know why. So why spend all of that time doing something that you don't really know what you're doing? But hire a social media manager to do that work for you, and you will thank us later, because we make your life so much easier. So that's what I do feel everybody should do. If you say can't afford one at this time, although it's an excellent investment, then this is something that you need to be doing 3 times a day. Post on social media 3 times a day, a minimum once a day, of your products. You know, talk about that, because people need to see that you're always open and that you're always out there. But another thing, make sure to pick apart, say, a day or 2 days to not work on business. You can check to see if you have any emails from customers. I do think you should do this at least once a day. Like for me, I do not do any business on Sundays. I catch myself checking emails more often than I should, or posting on Facebook, but I don't like work on Sundays, because that's my time. That is mine and Tom's time to just kind of take it easy. And I do not work past 6 o'clock. So I will not be, you know, following up with a client. I will not be checking in on a client, you know, like this or that, right? I will do that stuff during the day so that I can have my time. And so I can have my life too. So evenings are my time and Sundays are my time. So that way I don't get burnt out, because I was like you too, working constantly, literally from 9 in the morning till about 7 at night. But then at that point, I'd be so exhausted. I'd be like, okay, it's time to eat now. And then I'm exhausted. I'm just going to sleep. But was I making any money? Not necessarily, because I was in the early stages where I felt that I did have to be doing all of these things to be creating all of these things, to be making websites, doing social media, learning about websites, learning about social media. I was always working and I hated it. I thought to myself, why am I doing this? You know, I want to be able to relax and enjoy my hard work, but you can't if you don't take a step back. So if you need help with this, if you have questions, let me know, because this is so important. Because once you experience that burnout, you want to give up. And then if you do, now you don't have a business. And then all of your hard work was for nothing. So don't let that happen. Please, if you need somebody to talk to, let me know. And I will see you guys in the next video.